this really is the classic dilemma for Don Shula.
It's got to be a very difficult thing.
Sometimes people ask you what's the most thrilling such and such. A lot of the fun is taken out of a thrill because of the pressure and tension that's necessary to make it such a thrill.
And that's what we're all waiting to see. We're all sitting here tonight waiting to see Don Shula look across at David Shula and David look back to the other side. And if we're wondering how it's going to be, how do you think they feel?
Look across and say, you know, we want to whip their butts or something like that, but deep down, you know, he doesn't want to beat his
son. He absolutely cherishes and idealizes and idolizes while worrying about winning the football game.
That's a family thing, but the game comes first.
It's tough. It's tough. And I can't imagine, even begin to imagine, how he feels, except I know damn well he wants to win the football games.
And that's what it's going to be for, with both of them.
Welcome back to Riverfront Stadium in Cincinnati. Game time is just about 10 minutes away now. You know, with all the years I've known Don Shula, about 16 or so now, there's one thing more important than football to him, and that is family. And that's why this game, tonight's performance against the Bengals, is so important. He looks across the field and he sees David Shula, the young man he raised and who he's grown to admire and love. And now he has to go and try to beat him at a very difficult time. David Shula is 0-4. To both David and to Don, this is much, much more than just a football game.
David was never a little boy. He was always very mature, and he was always the leader of the rest. We had five children, and David was the oldest, and he was the one that everybody gathered around, and he was giving the instructions and doing the coaching at that time. So he got early experience.
I don't ever remember not thinking about being involved in football in some way, either as a player or as a coach or in some fashion. I always enjoyed it from the time of my earliest memories, and had opportunities to do other things, but in the end I've chosen to be a coach, and very thankful for that.
He never really had the opportunity to coach, but when he had that opportunity to coach, he just blended in real well. He helped people. He was a very good teacher, and that's important to a young football player, to have a teacher that will take the time to explain things to get them ready to play.
Just watching him through the years, working with his players and his staff and handling game situations, those are the traits I would say that come out.
Well, these are my three grandsons, Danny, Chris, and Matthew. And that's, I think, Dave's first year as head coach of Cincinnati. And they have the Cincinnati jerseys on. And this was my Christmas present. They took it and sent it to me with a calendar underneath. So this is how I keep track of the time and keep track of my nephews and how they're growing.
I had to check to make sure they're all still rooting for the Bengals because the Dolphins have been doing fairly well in recent years, and we've struggled a little bit. But no, they're excited about the chance to visit with their grandfather and the game. I know it, it'll be emotional for them, you know, they're very much in our corner, and I know they're wanting those Bengals to win.
You know, my daughters and Michael are sort of giving me the hint that, Dad, you know that we're going to be pulling for David. And you know, I say, I understand. And I really do, because they're very close, and David is new at what he's doing. And I certainly understand that. But Marianne, I'm sure, is going to be pulling for me, and she'll take whatever side of her family that she can have up there. And, you know, we're going to try to even it up.
For my father and I, there's no question. I know how intense he's going to be in, and competitive and wanting to win, and I know how I'm going to feel, my intensity level, and how much I'm going to want our team to win, but they're going to be in between. You know, the only thing that we know in this ball game is that there's going to be a Shula on the winning side.
There's probably not a greater tribute to a father than to have the son say, I want to be like Dad. You feel that way?
Well, I hope that that's how he feels, and that would be a tribute, and I'd be very proud, you know, if he says that and means it. And but I'm proud anyhow of David and the way that he's conducting his life.
You know, I'm a Dolphin fan. I'm a Don Shula fan. 364 days and 21 hours of the year this year, and for 3 hours on Sunday, they're the enemy, and he's the commander of the enemy.
Now, this is his football team against the team that I'm responsible for. So from that standpoint, it can't get any bigger.
And so the stage is set. Don Shula versus David Shula. The hype is gone. The national media that has ascended here at Riverfront Stadium can sit back and watch a football game. Don Shula and David Shula have done everything they possibly can. They've coached their teams, and now we've got to find out which is the better club. The Dolphins 3-1 trying to get back on the winning side, and David Shula and his Bengals trying to win a football game for the first time this year. Stay tuned. Kickoff is just a couple of minutes away right here on Channel 10. I'd like to thank everybody working on the show. It's been a great one here at Riverfront. We'll see you just a couple of minutes for the kickoff. I'm Jimmy Cefalo. Thanks for joining us. So long, everybody.